Hello, my name is Marco Röckstroh and I'm a musician and sound designer from Wuppertal in Germany. I'm into electronic music since 1988 as I discovered musical genres like techno, EBM, acid house or drum bass, and I started producing back in 1996. Sound design is a topic of passion for me, and I'm into sound design for almost two decades. And today I show you my studio environment and how I work and how I create sounds.
Basically about sounds or noises, I'm inspired by many things. Nature is a great source of inspiration with all its sounds, like crashing of the waves at the ocean, like a strong wind blowing above the rooftop, like the sound of the falling snow, like the screaming falcon who lives in the neighborhood, like those background noises of the traffic, like the sound of the river, or like the sound of the falling rain. Especially rain is a fantastic sound I can listen to for hours, and it's a very special noise to me and very inspiring. On the other side, I'm fascinated by the sounds of certain machines. And of course, I'm very interested in any kind of musically hardware and gear, like synthesizers, outboard effects, mixing consoles, tape machines, and the like. My studio is more to me than just a place to work, it's also a place of creation. And so I created this clearly structured place to work in a pleasing environment. I'm more the old school and haptic guy. I still prefer playing music from vinyls or tapes. The analog sounding of both mediums is still my favorite listening experience. To complete the picture, I also still prefer musical hardware with elements I can touch, like knobs, buttons or faders. They provide me much more direct access to the sound and they allow me to work in a much more musically way. Basically, I never feel the need to operate a giant equipment setup. I like to work in a more reduced environment with clear structures and less equipment to stay focused about my acoustic aims or visions. From time to time, I change the setup or parts of a gear to reduce my technical routines and to force myself to try out new techniques or to try out things in another way. On my own musical productions in dub techno, deep house, lounge or new jazz, I always worked on unique, self-created sounds with a lot of passion and curiosity. I always understood this as part of my personal, musically, signature. Working on my latest dub techno release ended up with having created thousands of sounds and loops ready to be used. I found the sound creations that inspired myself, but I decided to release them as sample library instead of using them myself on an upcoming release. And that's the story behind Echo Factory, Dub Techno Mechanisms Volume 1. Now about the core of my working process. I record most sounds direct and live to give them a human touch and some kind of a unique groove. I consider this as musical snapshot. After recording, I cut each sound to a precise loop, so I have a good base to play them back in endless circles. At this point, I manipulate the sounds in real time by using external effects like reverbs or delays. And additionally, I use the filters and EQs of the analog mixing console to add some analog flavor. Once recorded the manipulated audio files, I cut them to precisely loops again, and these are the sounds of the sample library. At least, I check the sounds technically, and if they will match the other sounds of the collection. Finally, I make sure that the naming of the audio files is logical and precisely enough for the users. Besides samples, I like the idea to provide certain sounds as instruments, so the users will have an option to play sounds in a more musically way. For that reason, I always create contact instruments with a custom user interface, so the users will have an easy access to all the required parameters of the sound. Creating instruments is challenging and demanding, but it's also lots of fun, and a job you always will learn something new about. On sound design, I always try to give my very best. I have some kind of roadmap in my head when creating sounds for a specific musical genre. but I also like to look beyond musical horizons and to stay open-minded. Of course, I like the thought that the users will be happy with the sound in the end and that they may be feel inspired. That's my primary aim. I hope this little movie gave you good impressions about my sounds and the way I create them and of what's behind all of that. Thanks for watching and all the best.